Have you had it with overcrowded campgrounds? With the units packed so close, you can almost touch your neighbor's RV and yours at the same time.
Yes, hi, do you have any open campsites tonight?
Are you fed up with impossible to get reservations?
Nothing.
Do you long for a campsite with lots of room that you can make your own and get away from it all in a beautiful location?
Then stay tuned, because we're going to tell you about a growing trend in the RV lifestyle.
Owning your own campsite.
Now, before we get started, can we ask a favor? We would really like it if you would do us a big favor and subscribe. Subscribe to our RV Lifestyle channel.
Please.
Say it again.
Please. Pretty please.
The more people who subscribe, the more YouTube will show this and the more the videos will be circulated. So please subscribe. There's a little button there that you can click, and then there's a little bell icon. If you click that, you'll be notified when we have new videos online. But please, 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 please. All right. Now, we're going to have some fun today.
We are. Going to show them a community that is different than most RV communities. It's a place where people buy their own land. They buy a site, a big hunk of land that's even waterfront property, and they own it, and they got a base. Whenever they need a place to camp, they can go there.
Now, it's on Kentucky Lake, but it's not in Kentucky.
No, it's in Tennessee.
And we'll tell you.
The Tennessee River.
Yeah, we'll tell you, but they call it Kentucky Lake. We'll tell you all about that coming up. Now, we have been to resorts before where you can buy your lot, but they're a traditional, you know, lot, you know, a narrow lot in an RV park. This one is different because you're actually buying a pretty good hunk of property.
You get a big hunk of property. You can have it right on the lake, so you got waterfront property, and it's a whole community, and this is becoming very popular.
And you can do pretty much whatever you want. You can put whatever you want on your hunk of property there. And I think the best way for us to do it is to show you. But before we do that, we want to explain that we have no commercial relationship with this company at all. They're not a sponsor. We didn't get any financial remuneration. We just were curious. We had heard from a bunch of our viewers about this. And we happened to be in Middle Tennessee, and so we called them up, and they agreed to give us a tour.
This is something that is the future. As people kind of burn out trying to find a place to spend the night, they're getting so that they want a spot. And so a lot of this type of arrangement, this type of buying property for your RV is happening all over the country.
So come on along.
This is what is known as Kentucky Lake. It's a major waterway that starts in Kentucky, hence its name, and winds 245 square miles through Kentucky and most of Middle Tennessee. It's technically a reservoir made by the Tennessee Valley Authority in 1944 when they dammed up the Tennessee River.
So you can call it Kentucky Lake or the Tennessee River, but here is where the RV development is located. The first phase is all sold out. They're about to open phase two. Tom Spychalski is with the development company behind marketing the property.
RV parks are filling up quickly. Boondocking is you know, popular, but it's becoming more prohibitive to boondock in places, and it doesn't feel as secure to a lot of people. So ownership versus renting has really become a trend, and we've tapped into that. We get lakefront properties, turn them into something that you can own that's bigger than an RV lot, typically.
How big is this land compared to what you would find in a traditional RV park where you buy a lot?
Yeah. Lots in RV parks, you're looking at 14 by 60, you know, dimensions typically. We're looking at acreage. So they start out at about a third of an acre, which is pretty big for even for a lake house. To put a house on, that's fairly big lot. So they start at that size and then go up to several acres. So it's we try to make it, so you can do gardening and you can landscape and have space around or invite friends over for RVing on your property as well. It's something that is yours. It's equity. It's permanent. It's available when you want it. It's not, you're not sharing it in any way. All the utilities and the sewer system, it's all yours. You can put your own private dock on your lakefront property.
And you are right on the lake.
In a sensational way.
This is phase one of their development, and as you can see, it's a gated community. We'll go in and we'll take a look at some of the property out there, see if we can sign some of the local folks who have bought here to tell us a little bit about it. So you can put your own pad, your own cement pad, as big as you want, nice and level. Many of the spots that we're seeing have built in a sun cover to keep the rain and the sun off your RV, which you leave inside. And of course, out your front door is the lake.
It's beautiful here. There's eagles, turtles, river otters, which are just ridiculous. Geese with babies, which just went by yesterday. It was like a whole parade of youngins here going right up the river. It's quiet.
Yeah, the coyotes, we got to be careful though.
Oh, well, yeah, the coyotes. But they're not around here. And foxes, just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful nature, just gorgeous. And then the river is spectacularly beautiful.
It's kind of nice to be removed from things, though. That's kind of makes it the ideal place. It's far enough away that you don't feel like you need to worry about anything.
Do you ever think you'd have a place on a lake like this?
No, not really.
Yeah.
We come down a year ago just to look and fell in love with it and bought same day.
Really?
Really.
Is that the way you've operated all your life?
Quite a bit of the time, yeah.
Sound like me.
Yeah.
So tell me, what is the appeal of a place like this?
Well, the appeal of here is being on the river. This is part of the big loop, so this thing goes forever. You buy property on a lake, you just go round and round and round. So that's what really appealed to me, was being on the river.
And some people call that a lake, too, out there.
Yeah, right, it's called Kentucky Lake, Tennessee River.
Yep. Now, are you going to put in a dock and everything?
Yes.
Yeah. And tell us what your plans are here. We've got that big...
Well, we've got a boat at home, a 22-foot pontoon boat at home we're bringing down. We're going home Friday. We ain't been home since 12th of January. We went to Florida for 3 months. Come here for two weeks and going home for 2 weeks, back here for a while, and we're traveling. We got the RV now, and we're both retired, and we're going to go full-time RV and just go and make this our base plate.
It's just absolutely beautiful. I love Tennessee.
Have you started to say y'all yet?
Not yet.
Now, the people who own this lot, actually this is like a double lot, they are from California. And neighbors tell me that they don't even plan to stay here other than maybe a week or two a year. What they're going to do is they've turned it into what they call the Double Islands Retreat. There are a couple of islands out in front here, and they're going to rent those out, kind of like a Airbnb for RVs. They're going to turn that into a business. There's a lot of different ways that you can use this property, and you can become a landlord if you want. If you're curious about flooding, you should know that this is all run by the Tennessee Valley Authority, and it is probably one of the most regulated waterways in all of America. So they basically can control all the levels. And obviously, you met all the people who are living on it. They haven't had any problem at all. So it's pretty neat. All this riverfront.
Well, I hope you noticed that I wasn't in that video. I hope you missed me. And the reason I wasn't there with Mike, I really wanted to go there. I was back at the campground because we were working on another story and I had to be there, but I felt like I got gypped.
Yep. But, well, now you got to see the video.
Yeah, but it's not quite the same.
I did miss you.
Well, that's good.
I'm sure it would have been a better story.
Oh, it would have been much better, and Bo would have enjoyed it as well.
But anyway, it's a neat operation. I think you're going to see more of these kind of places cropping up around the country. We'll put information in the description below if you want to check out this property that we saw a little bit more in Tennessee. Meantime, as we said at the beginning, we sure hope you'll subscribe to the RV Lifestyle channel right here on YouTube. Don't forget, click the bell icon, then you'll be notified when we have new videos online. We're Mike and Jennifer Wendland. Thank you guys for watching.
Happy trails!